Because he did it. He initiated it. He says, if you come in believing, I'm giving you all grace. All grace. If you come in believing, I'm giving you all grace. I'll sign up for that deal any day. But Brother James says, Williams, you can come in, but you've got to cut the grass, you've got to wash dishes. Don't get in my chair. Don't even look at my chair. I don't touch my fishing. Okay. Verse 8 says, wherein he had done what? Abounded toward us, aggressed toward us, all wisdom and prudence. Now, verse 9. Having made unto us known unto us the what?
The mystery of his will.
Mystery of his will. The mystery of his will. The mystery. Now someone, please tell me, what is that mystery of God's will?
I'll stab it.
What is the mystery? Okay, what's the mystery of God?
The Gentiles will be brought in.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Look at 1 Peter. This is after Peter had gotten schooled by Paul. Peter is able to say these things. You can go with verse 2.
The first.
And we're going to work through verse 5.
Is this chapter 1?
Yeah, 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 2. Go ahead. Got it?
Elect according to the foreknowledge of God.
Okay, first of all, who is he talking to? Jew or Gentile?
That's Jew.
Jew. See, we, you know, somebody said, turn to that today. We'll say, that's us. You a natural born Jew? No. You're a natural born Gentile, so you're not elect. Oh. I mean, the seed of Jews are the elect. We got to put this in the right perspective because you'll see how the gospel, Paul says, Romans 1:16, to the who first?
Jew
first. Then to the Gentiles. That's the way God got it. We're just second-class citizens until we get in Christ. So he says, elect.
According to the foreknowledge of God the Father, through sanctification of the Spirit and to obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ, grace be unto you, and peace be multiplied.
Yeah, so in other words, Jew, you got to start believing. You got to start believing in your Messiah. Okay, verse 3, what it says.
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
Believe in your Messiah has come, and he's risen from the dead. Verse 4.
To an inheritance incorruptible, undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you.
Who
are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time.
Okay, so the power of God through faith, elect. You got to believe in your Messiah to experience his power. Now, okay. We're trying to look at this mystery. Verse 10.
Of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently, who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you.
The prophets tried to explain it, didn't quite get it all the way out about this grace that should come to you. Searching what manner of time the Spirit of Messiah, which was in them, did signify when it testified before the sufferings of Messiah and the glory that shall come. So we've been talking to you Jews, us prophets, and the law, have been doing this forever and ever and ever for a long time, trying to get you ready for your Messiah. Let's go, jump into Romans 16:25. See if that can help us make some sense. It might. Okay. How long has this mystery been unfolding? 16:25 and 26. Anybody got it? Okay, go ahead.
You said Romans 16.
Okay. 16 verse 25.
Now to him that is of power to establish you according to my gospel and the preaching of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery, which was kept secret since the world began. But now it is made manifest by the scriptures of the prophets according to the commandment of the everlasting God made known to all nations. For the obedience of faith.
All right, that's some heavy reading there. Mm-hmm. Now to him that is of power, establish you according to the way that I preach, what I've been delivering, the preaching of Messiah, according to the revelation of the mystery, which was kept secret since the world began. And we read in Galatians that mystery was revealed to Paul by God. It came to Paul. Paul was designated to receive that mystery when he was in his mother's womb. On the road and after of Damascus experience, God started revealing that mystery to him. Peter, John, Matthew, Ananias, and what's the guy who asked Jesus how to be born again? Nicodemus, they out. They don't know nothing about this. They don't know nothing. They got a glimpse of it, but the prophets told us about Messiah. That's why Mary and them and Elizabeth was prepared for Messiah. But they don't know much more. And a lot of times, saints are out preaching and teaching and going on. They don't know much either. It's like Priscilla and Aquila, when they was preaching and doing some good work on the ground in evangelism, Paul says, you know what, God? He says, what? I got to sit you down and give you some more information. Really? Yeah. Another example pointed out in scriptures, Acts 19, without getting off subject, Acts 19 and 3. I'm saved. Yeah, you're saved. But have you what? Received the Holy Ghost since you believed. What? Never heard of that. Oh, there's a whole abundance of churches like that. We heard about Messiah. Yeah, we know the Easter story. Yeah, we got it going on. Wait a minute. Have you come into the knowledge as it revealed? What? Never heard of it like that. That's okay. We're going to keep running again. I'm just trying to. Okay. Now, verse 26 is now it's obvious. How is it obvious? By the word. The scriptures of who? The prophets. It's obvious. Look in there, you'll see your Messiah. Obvious by the scriptures of the prophets, according to the commandment of the everlasting God, he initiated this, made known to who? All nations. All nations now, not just the Jewish nation, all nations. And how do I benefit by this? Faith. Faith. No do's and don'ts. Oh, wait a minute. Paul said a little bit somewhere around here that in the Old Testament scriptures, you won't find what? Faith. You can hang around there if you want to, but you won't find no faith in those Old Testament scriptures. Faith? Yeah, faith is what? You got to have faith in this Messiah. Now, hold on. We're going to keep running. Did we do John 17:24?
Not yet.
Maybe we should take a look at that. And here he's saying that, and I got to keep an eye on the time, because it's a tendency to get away from here.
Brother Williams, what was the Acts scripture?
I said something about Acts 19 and 3.
Acts
19 and 3. And there's another something in there. But then I'm going to go to St. John 17, right? 24. Father, I will that they also, whom thou hast given me, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me. For thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. See, that's all initiated before planet Earth came into being. God had all this initiated. Okay, now we're going to get to our lesson. That's what we ain't going to do. Now, verse 9 of our lesson, Ephesians 1:9. Having made known unto us the what? The mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he purposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of times, since the recorded history, every dispensation, every time period, Messiah is there. Do you recognize him? That in the dispensation of the fullness of times, he might gather together in one all things in Christ. So when that end time message come around, or whatever, Christ is there. Here in today's time, he's here. And back in before he died on the cross, he was in that time period. In Abraham's time period, he was there. Jesus says, Abraham, Abraham knew me. Abraham knew nothing about you. Abraham recognized me. That's how he got in faith with the Father. He recognized me. He said, before Abraham, I was. Mm-hmm. Oh. Okay, so, and that he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are what? In heaven, which are on earth, even in him. So eventually, everybody's going to see that this Messiah has control of everything. And his headquarters is going to be in Jerusalem. He's going to rule everything. The day is going to come. If we'll see it, if we don't die before the rapture, he'll be ruling everything from Jerusalem, his headquarters. The whole creation, which is where it was planned from the beginning, that he would rule over his whole creation on the earth. Now, that's a strange preaching there. It's going to be a man in Jerusalem controlling the whole earth. Y'all see me on YouTube? So a man in Jerusalem ruling the whole earth. Now, can you believe that? Yeah. Can you believe a man rose up from the dead? Yeah. That was Paul's challenge, just like it is my challenge to say it's going to be a man from Jerusalem,
all right,
controlling the whole earth. Wow! I said, Paul, you're nuts. Williams, you're crazy. That's what's going to happen. Yeah. So, here we go. Okay. In whom also we have obtained, verse 11, what?
An inheritance.
Being predestined according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of us. God initiated all of this. That's what Paul is saying. I haven't dreamed this up. This is what God did. Now, that we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ. Did he turn around? He's got a crowd in front of him. How many know how to give a speech? Sister Hill, you know how to give a speech? You was in drama, wasn't you? Was
yes.
What's your eyes supposed to do?
You canvas
the whole room.
Yeah.
Right.
Don't look.
Right. And then when I'm going to speak to a particular bunch of people, make my point, I go, talking to you, trying to win you, trying to get to you. And that when he said that right there, that's where his eyes fell on the Jewish crowd. That we should be, in verse 11, in whom also we have what?
Obtained inheritance.
As Jews, we have obtained. We got it. We have the goods. Verse 12, that we should be to the praise of his glory. In other words, us Jewish people, we should be appreciating what he has given us through Father Abraham. Jew first, to the Jew first, then to the Greek. Who first trusted in who? Messiah. A Jew was the first person to trust in Messiah. His name was Abraham. While he's looking at the crowd, his eyes fall on them. He says, "You dummies, you got Abraham, and you don't even know what you got." Uh-oh. You see why they threw stones at him. And then he's circling the crowd with his eyes, and then he falls on another crowd. And that's where he says, verse 13, in what? In whom you Gentiles also trusted.
After you heard.
Faith come by what?
Hearing.
So after you, and now you Gentiles, he's circled the room again, and you Gentiles now trust in him after you what? Heard. Struck up the music class dance. The word of truth. The gospel of what?
Your salvation.
Uh-oh. In whom also, after that, you believe. You are what?
The Holy Spirit.
If I take your Bibles away, it'll make no difference. You still what it says. Because you sealed. The Holy Ghost sealed you up. You can't no more get away from Christ and deny him if you wanted to. Is that somewhere in John's book and letters, it says, the seed is planted. You just can't. You don't enjoy sin like you used to before you heard this good news. Somebody leave a pound of marijuana on my porch and then just be sweeping up with the rest of the leaves.
My team,
so-and-so wouldn't gonna be like that. But somebody dropped a bundle on my porch right now, sweep it up and throw it in the trash. It has no value to it. But after I got sealed with that Holy Ghost of promise, whoa, this ain't the same. I wonder if Timothy knows anything. They probably know what I'm talking about. Also, after that, you believe you were sealed with that Holy Ghost of promise, which is the earnest of what? Our inheritance. So he's talking about coming into the family. Everybody's in the inheritance. Until the redemption of the purchased possession. So, you're in the family, you got to act like you're in the family. My little grandson made a mistake the other day. He didn't know. But he said, we can't get that for Christmas because it costs so much money. And if we spend that on me, then everybody else won't get it. Who told you that? And when we told them that, they in trouble. Guess what? Who? They don't be teaching these kids limitations. Who do you think you are?
Uh-oh.
There ain't no limitations. We got as much money as you want to buy. Whatever you want to give them, you get them. You don't even consider limitations. You know who you are. In the next week, the story changed. But because we are accustomed to being outside of the family, not being able to sit in Williams' favorite chair, go into his refrigerator loaded with food. We're just not accustomed to doing that. So we gotta go look for a Ford Pinto. What's the name of the shoe store? Carnival Circle?
Shoe carnival.
What is that, carnival circle? Shoe carnival. We want the low grade of life, and God's got the best fruit for you. All you got to do is what? Come in the family. Believe the message and come in the family. And he says, that's why he says he's blessed us with what? Everything. But if you don't see, you don't think you can deliver, then you don't believe and you don't get. Because it's all based on belief. Hallelujah. I got a question. Keep going, I'll be at the church. But I love the story of redemption through the Messiah. Redemption is in him. Glory to God.